when you look at this series, you'd automatically make Edmonton a favorite based on the way the two clubs finished the season.
Obviously, we made it this year, which is great, and we're looking to do some damage in the playoffs and be a good playoff team.
To win in the playoffs, it's a total team game. But when you have elite talents, it gives you a chance to be successful.
If you're not playing as a group out there, then you're never going to have success. So I think that's one thing we've really, you know, done well this year.
Struggle in the playoffs in previous years, you're definitely hungrier. That's something that I can definitely see in this team, and the top guys on this team are, you know, they're desperate and they're hungry to win. So that's a huge component, I think, of what you need on a winning team.
The Edmonton Oilers and the Winnipeg Jets, the second and third seeds respectively in the North Division.
It's a different animal in playoffs, so we got to prepare for that. And I think we've done everything right to this point, and obviously it's all going to start tonight.
Both of these teams are raring to go.
Game one, round one, and the race to four is underway.
Hellebuck takes a peek and directs a pass. Oh, and just getting smoked was DeMello by Josh Archibald. A walloping hit. Dominic Toninato over the line. Vesalainen a shot. The glove save made. Went into rebuild. Here's a shot by Berrios. He enters the zone. Quick shot score. Yessopulyarvi on the rebound. He found it. The Jets did it. And Yessopulyarvi making his National Hockey League playoff debut has scored Edmonton's first postseason goal.
What a story Puljujärvi has become for Edmonton this season.
Drops it off for Wheeler. A wrist shot. And they score. The Jets tie this one. Tucker Poolman comes in to help out. And it's 1-1 here between the Jets and the Oilers. Leon Draisaitl. Larson, one-timer. It's in front. It's in the blue paint. Hellebuck didn't know where it was.
Shook off a check out to Stanley, and he fired it off the post.
The way that kicked out, I thought it might have gone in, Jack.
Yeah, that's it. It went post, back bar, and out. After first catching a piece of Mike Smith.
Very nice play to keep it alive for the Oilers. Nice move by Draisaitl, and an even better save by Hellebuck. Wheeler, he's got an opportunity with the open net, and the Jets have a 4-1 lead.
Wheeler just pounces on that, puts the shoulder down, and finishes it off. And for the Winnipeg Jets, they're going to win game number one.
You know, I actually didn't mind our game. I thought we did a lot of good things. I thought we had the puck a lot of the night, played in their zone, put a lot of pucks there. You know, just didn't find a way to get to get one. That's the way it goes. They get a tip. We don't. You know, let's play off hockey.
The Edmonton Oilers look to even this best of seven series against the Winnipeg Jets, a team against whom they've never lost a postseason series.
Now it's Mason Appleton finds Lowry going towards the net, makes a move, and Mike Smith, a great save, rebound, and Smith has the answer.
No score, Winnipeg and Edmonton. Oilers have dropped off the draw, quick shot, save, what a stop by Mike Smith on the rebound against Kyle Connor. He was down and out, but got the right pad up. Two remarkable saves right off the draw.
Here's Andrew Kopp. Mano a mano, and Mike Smith makes the save. He got a piece of it. He had to lay down. That's right. Now here comes Leon Draisaitl towards the net. A backhand shot. Oh, what a stop by Connor Hellebuck.
Hellebuck just stays strong with that left pad. Look at the extension at the last second.
Scoreless game. One-timer, Draisaitl save made. Jason tied up. Wrist shot. And McDavid could not thread it through. Hellebuck was down and out. The net was wide open. And somehow the Jets kept it out. We're heading for overtime in game two of the Stanley Cup playoffs. We've settled nothing through 60 minutes. The shots 35-34 for the Jets. And in a game that's every bit as close as one would suspect, we've got a goaltender's duel, an absolute classic between Mike Smith and Connor Hellebuck. Take it away, and it's Andrew Kopp on the counter left to right.
finds Paul Stastny. Right circle, shoots and scores! And Paul Stastny has won it at 4:06 of overtime. The Jets lead the best of seven series, 2-0.
Give them credit, they're playing a really tight game. They're not taking any chances, giving us any odd man rushes, but we've had some looks and we got to capitalize on them. We got to find a way to get one on that power play, and we got all the confidence in the world that we're going to be able to score goals, so we just got to stick with it.
We have a team that is capable of show up in our next game in two nights and start to hopefully get some bounces our way and start to build off something. So I don't think anyone in our room is going to sit back and feel bad for ourselves or feel like we're so far out of this one. There's a lot of work to be done. It's not going to be easy whatsoever. They're playing a really good, strong team game, but it's a challenge that we got to be up to meet.
Edmonton, Winnipeg from Bell MTS Place in Winnipeg, Manitoba, where the Oilers had a great deal of success this year, but that was during the regular season. And as they found, the postseason has been a brand new situation. Winnipeg has won the first two of this best of seven first round series.
Starts important. Obviously, this is a massive game for us tonight.
McDavid to the point. Cuckoo lets one go. Here's a chance for Draisaitl, and they score! It didn't take as long. We have the game's first goal, and it's Leon Draisaitl who gives the Oilers a one-goal lead.
Close doesn't get you anything if you're not winning games. So it's close. You got to find ways to find that little extra. With that being said, you got to find ways to get through it, get over it, and find ways to win.
Yamamoto in tight, trying to jab it home. Draisaitl scores! And the Oilers have a 2-0 lead here in the first period. Luke Dubois with it. The Oilers. Shoots, scores! Top shelf! And the Winnipeg Jets are on the board thanks to Nikolaj Ehlers. Taken by McDavid, it's a 3-on-2 with Draisaitl and Cassian. Draisaitl centers, Cassian shoots and scores! And Edmonton right back in front by a deuce. It's Zach Cassian with the goal.
In there to grab it is Shore, now to Larson. A shot for the point, and they score again! A three-goal lead now in the third period for the Oilers.
What a tip by Carey in tight.
The only man to beat Smith tonight. Dubois, one-timer save made by Smith. Rebound chipped home. And the Jets may not be done yet. Scheifele back to Morrissey. The shot. Smith the save. Rebound. Wheeler scores. And we have a one-goal game. The captain puts the Jets within one. Morrissey just set up one goal for the tie. He scores! Through Mike Smith, and we are tied at four. The Jets, a stunning comeback, and Edmonton's 4-1 lead has completely evaporated. Two goals in 16 seconds.
We're in a good spot, obviously, up 4-1. They go on the power play, and we can't get a kill, and kind of gave them a lifeline there, and they took advantage, obviously.
Winning is hard, and there's painful lessons that you learn. You need to learn to win. And like you say, we were pretty good at it all year, but tonight we learned some hard lessons on what not to do to win in the playoffs.
About midway through overtime, off the draw, wrist shot, score! Winnipeg has won game three, 5-4 in overtime. It's Nick Ehlers right off the draw, top right corner. Jets lead the series 3-0.
Four goals in a playoff game should be enough to win the game, right? So that's not an issue to score goals. We know how to do it. We've done it all year. It's on the other side of the puck.
We're not going to roll over and play dead on these guys. I mean, we got to find a way to get a win tomorrow night, and we'll take it from there.
It's do or die for the Edmonton Oilers, staring at a 3-0 series deficit and trying to do what no Oiler club has ever done, and that's win a game when they've been down 3-0 in a best of seven. They'll have Mike Smith with their season on the line.
2-on-1 developing. Ehlers to Dubois. What a great save! McDavid shoots a two. What a great save by Hellebuck.
Wheeler back
door. One-timer score, Mark Scheifele, power play goal. And the Jets have made it 1-0 at 6:16 of the first period. That's Scheifele's first goal of the series. Puljujärvi ahead for McDavid. Drop pass, Draisaitl. Back to McDavid. Cuts behind. Wraparound score, and this game is tied. Connor McDavid's first goal of the series. And Edmonton has squared it at 1.
On the boards, Morrissey. Shot for the point, and it's in the net!
With a terrific little deflection.
Middle of the ice, Nugent Hopkins launched. Save made, Hellebuck, rebound, score! Nugent Hopkins ties the game at 2 with his first goal of the series and his third career playoff goal, and Edmonton very much alive in game 4.
Nugent Hopkins, one-timer, Draisaitl, Chiasson scores! Power play marker, and the Oilers have a 3-2 lead.
Saved by Hellebuck off the body of Chiasson, and a great patient play to just wait out, tuck it around the pad of Hellebuck.
A centering pass, Connor, one-timer score! Mark Scheifele has tied the game. His second of the night, and it's 3-3 with 14 minutes left.
There's things that happen in a game that the only way you can figure them out is to go through them, and that's, unfortunately, that's some of the challenges we're going through right now.
Connor circles, Scheifele shoots, Smith gets a piece of it.
This is off the draw, wrist shot and a blocker save made by Smith. What a chance for Winnipeg. Appleton could not believe that didn't go in off the draw.
McDavid to Draisaitl, and that's wide.
Muscled up, centering pass. Ehlers, a shot denied. Smith point blank range. The Oilers and the Jets have slogged their way through 100 minutes. As the Oilers and the Jets play triple overtime.
Stolen by Short. Stolen again, Short! But he can't put the puck in the net.
And Winnipeg down the other way. Kyle Connor's got a breakaway. Wrist shot, score! Connor wins it! 4-3 in triple overtime. And the Jets have swept the Edmonton Oilers.
It was a long one, and we tried to, we gave it everything we had. So at the end of the day, you don't want to leave anything out there, and I don't think we did tonight. We battled, Smitty battled, all the guys battled, so it's disappointing because, I feel like we got a lot of hockey left in this room, so tough way to go.
It's just disappointing at this point. I mean, we battled all night. I mean, 3 overtimes. This is the 3rd overtime game in 4 games. I mean, there's not much. Not much to say, except it's tough to swallow right now.
Played hard. That sucks because we're sitting here after 4 games and it's a sweep. We took 3 to overtime, so there's things that we could have done better here in the end, but I honestly don't know how to answer that.
Had 2 years in a row here. We've got in. We've got to continue to improve. There's some building blocks that are in place that we need to continue to build on. But we want to be a playoff team every year. Give ourselves a chance to compete for the cup every year. So there's some hard lessons you learn along the way. But right now it feels a little bit hollow with the way things went in the playoffs.
We don't need to leave here and think we gotta rewrite the ship here. Like, it's little things. It's a fine line, and we talked about those lessons I guess we've learned throughout the years, and it's obviously another lesson that we got to take with us moving forward.